This tutorial will show how to create and check the complex composite column shown using CSiCOL. We start by going to the Draw, Add Basic Concrete Shape command, where we have many options to choose from, including defined sections from a library, but we will start with a circular section. We wish to change the dimensions of the circle, so make sure that the Select tool is on and select the section. Then go to the Edit, Edit Current Shape command. The Shape Editor form that opens is very powerful, as it will allow us not only to change the geometry of the section, but also to place reinforcing later on. We will change the diameter to 24 inches, and then update the display. A last check is to make sure that the material selection is acceptable. Next, we will add an arbitrary shape using the Draw Shape command. Using this command, we can draw any closed polygon shape. Once drawn, we can edit the shape by selecting it and going to the Edit, Edit Shape Coordinates command, where we can alter the coordinates of one or more points. We could have also added the polygon shape by directly entering the point coordinates, rather than by drawing it as we did. Now that both concrete shapes have been drawn, we will merge them together. Click on the Reshape tool and select the polygon. This allows us to slide the polygon over to the circular section. Next, click on the Select tool and select both sections. Then go to the Edit, Merge Two Shapes Using Intersection Logic command. This merges the two shapes into a single object. The next step is to define the reinforcing. Select the section and go to the Edit Current Shape command. We will add the rebar using the rebar calculator, and we'll locate 32 number 7s around the perimeter. We can add additional bars with a single mouse click. Now we will add the steel section for composite behavior. The Draw Add Basic Steel Shape command offers a number of choices, including, again, defined sections from a library. We will select an eye or wide flange shape. Select the steel section and go to the Edit Current Shape command. On the Shape Editor form, we verify that the material is correct, and then change the width and depth of the section to 14 inches. With the steel wide flange section still selected, we go to the Edit Rotate command to rotate the section 90 degrees. Now that the geometry of the column section is completely defined, we will assign the loads. The program shows a single default combination to which we will add a second combination. With the loads complete, we can now check the design by viewing the capacity ratios. Our capacity ratios are all under 1, so our column appears adequate for the loads defined. Next, we can display the interaction diagrams, including the PM, MM, and interaction surface curves. The 3D interaction surface is quite narrow, as we would expect based on the geometry and orientation of the composite column. We can also display the stresses in the cross-section. And any view displayed may be added to the report. To view the current report, go to the File, Preview, Current Report command. Here you may generate a report describing the column in detail and the design results. Note that the report includes the stress diagram previously added. This concludes this tutorial.